on this pillar. You must pop out this thing. You must from here pop out. Under this, you have this clip. You must remove it. You have a clip here. This clip. Use a plastic tool. Started from this side. Sometimes it's easy to remove them. Sometimes it's hard. Okay. This is here. Okay. Okay, it's free. And you can pull
normally.
Okay, you start pulling from this corner. It came out easy. Okay. Now we remove the wires to see what we have here. We have a lot of wires. Okay.
Good. Removal tool and pry this part out here. And then pry it out like this. And then you have to do the same to this side as well. This is why we need to open up the window in order to remove this window trim piece. So you just need to get under it right here. See there? Notice how I'm prying that off. As soon as you pry this off, you can pull it out a bit and it will come out. We don't need to take it off all the way. We just need to remove it enough so that we can get to the most annoying clip piece you've ever seen. There's going to be a capital H looking clip here. This is the push clip right here underneath the window trim right here. This is how I remove it. I use a plier-like tool with a really good grip, okay? And it is a H-style clip. So you just have to grab it here and then pull this out, okay? There we go. When I first removed this clip, I was having so much trouble. I was prying it like this, from the bottom, from the sides, always. But honestly, the best way that I have found to remove this clip is, what I do is I come underneath and you can see that there are these two prongs that slide down a bit. I use my pick tool and I get underneath and I pull that down like so, and then it frees the top one out. And then you do the same to the bottom, and then you can pull it out like so. Now I'm going to show you what it looks like. So having a look at it, as you can see, there are two tabs, one on the top here and one on the bottom. There's one there and there's another one here. This is what it looks like. As you can see, it is a H-style clip. So you have to grab a pair of pliers that has a good grip, like so, and then grab on the edge and pull it out. There are two tabs, one on the top and one on the bottom. And that's what holds it in place. So, in order to remove it, you need to get these two tabs to press in, like so. That's why I used a pick tool and went in from underneath. Because if you look inside, you notice how there's these tabs that come down? That's what holds it in place. So when you push this H-clip back in, this tab right here. So, now we also need to remove the tweeter cover in order to remove it easily. What I normally do is I just come up the top here and then pry it out like so, and it will just come out. And then from here, you can just simply remove it. Okay, just be careful not to break any of the clips. It's clipped in at three points. Okay, there's one, two, and three. There's one, come off. I'm just going to remove this foam piece here. Now you don't have to remove it, but I like to remove it just so I have more room. And look at that, that just comes off. Just in case I scratch anything, I'm going to put some microfiber cloth. We can now begin to pry off the door from the door clips that hold the door in all along they unclipped all the clips that surround the door on the outside. Now, in order to take off the door, it hooks in from the top as well. And pry, you hear that clip? Next one, down here where the separate, where the door is, and just keep working your way through. There we go, that's another one. Okay, and then down the bottom, then do the same to the other side. You want to make sure you're working your way all around the door. So I'll do the bottom now. Okay, there we go. Now, as you could see there, all I did was... So I'm going to lift it over the door pin. And now from here, there are going to be wires connected. This is where your pick tool is going to come in handy. So after we've lifted it off the doorknob, we need to remove the door latch. So you need to pull it out so the cable can slide out and then lift it out of the door handle. Like that. You notice how it's hooked in right here? You just have to pull this back here because you notice how it's sitting in this groove right here. In order to remove it out, you need to pull it back so it's just cable showing and then lift it out like that. And then you just have to lift it out of this right here, the door handle. Just keep lifting it out and it will come out like so. As you can see, this part just simply sits in here. So you just have to pull the cable back and then lift it out and that frees that up. And then all we have left are two cables. You have two cables that are connected to the door. Okay, and now all you have to do in order to be able to remove the door completely is remove these other two plugs and then the door will come completely off. So in order to remove it, you notice this tab here. All you have to do is press on that tab and pull it out. I'm just doing it with one hand at the moment so you guys can see. So that's one plug out. Same thing to the blue one. Just press on the tab and pull it out. Two. Okay, that's the door off. Also, make sure that you have all your door clips. Okay guys, so now that we have removed the door panel, as you can see from here, you can get to different components behind the three along the side. If they are not in there, make sure you didn't drop them. Or make sure they're not still in the door, and if they are, remove them and put them back in the appropriate slots. They just simply slide in like this. Also, from here, as door light, there's the cable for it. It runs along the bottom and then runs up here. It shares the power source for your boot. Is reattach the door latch, so we put this hook back into this hole
to these matte silver ones here. As you can see right here, these are matte silver door handles. But also at the same time, you're going to see how you go about repairing the door handle. This is a common fault with the W handle and also 20 Phillips screwdrivers that have a washer. Now, the reason why you get 20 screwdrivers is because in order to remove the door handle, what you need to do is cut 20 melted tabs, and once you cut the melted tabs, the only way to resecure it is either by melting it again or by using the screws that they supply. Now, if you're thinking that these screws aren't going to do the job, I can guarantee you now that they definitely do work. And let's get into it. Let's unplug the plugs that we need to unplug first. Get a pick tool. Like I always say, guys, you really need to get yourself a set of pick tools because they really are a great tool to use. I use it for all my DIYs because they really come in handy. Let's just remove these five aluminium 10mm nuts. It's two, three, four, five. Take them out. Three, four, five. The trim piece will now just drop out. Push it out. That releases our trim piece. It also releases the trim around our buttons. As you can see right here, the one aluminium nut on this side releases this entire piece. So make sure you unplug everything. Disconnect the LED light here. There we go. Let's remove the two T10 screws here. Now, if they could use T10 screws here, why couldn't they just use screws all on these plastic tabs here as well? Mercedes have to be difficult and they just gotta do what they gotta do, eh? This is the tool that I'm using in order to cut it off. If you're gonna try and melt these, you're probably going to damage this as well. So, you know, I figured it's probably easier to just cut it off. All you do is just put it underneath and cut it. That's it. Do the same to the other side and cut. Repeat that for every single one. Now you only want to cut off the plastic tab and leave the center because that's where your screw's going to go in order to secure it later. I'm just checking that I have cut it properly and it will separate after I pry it apart. Okay, so you can see that it does pry apart here. Very good. Perfect. All right, so as you can see, it is now separated. I've never done this before, guys. This is my first time, so wish me luck. You also have to cut off these two rectangular tabs here as well. They are also melted on it. And after that, you also have to cut these two circular ones here as well. Once you do that, you will be able to remove the centerpiece with the door handle from the door panel itself. I'm gonna show you guys how to do that now. All right, so you lift this one up, you separate it. It's also a good idea to remove your orange ambient light. Be very careful how you remove this because as you can see here, I have already broken mine. See, it's already been broken off. Okay, so that sits in like this. In order to remove this, you have two clips here. You take it out from here, pry these clips back, take it out of here. You take it out of here as well. And then in order to remove it from here, it's clipped in via two clips in here. You just have to pry it out like that. That's how you remove this clip. I accidentally broke mine. That's all right. I'm just going to glue it back together and it should go back together okay. But don't make the same mistake I did. That's also why I do these videos as well, so you guys don't make the same errors that I make. I am no professional. I simply DIY, teach myself how to do things, and I do make mistakes along the way, and you know, that's okay. I'm only human after all. Once you pry this apart, you will be able to remove it easily because it's just sitting in here. Now to remove it, you lift this one up and you'll see where it's connected in. So I showed you guys that there is, and now this piece comes out. There you go. And that's how you remove this piece. And now that we have this out, in order to release the door handle, we need to take out this pivot screw. I like to make a little dent in it with a screw and then drill a tiny little hole in it so we can start it off and then use a screw to pull it out. Right. Now we'll grab our screw because we've started it off. We can get our screw in, put it in there, screw it into it, couple of threads, and now I'm able to pull it out like so. There we go. That's the only way you're going to get it out, and it's the easiest way to get it out as well. So that's what you want to do, guys. Now this door handle will come out. We have to transfer this plastic clip over to our new door handle. And even if you accidentally break this, you can always replace it. There we go. You just push it in together and push it, and it comes right out. Okay, so we've got our door handle in. Make sure it's installed the right way, like so. And we know that this has to install onto the top here, like so. Just push it on through. Now we grab our pivot for the door handle and we push it on in from the bottom right here. Push it in and it should lock it in and clip in. You just push it on in, there we go. And it's in now. Yep, it's all the way in and it's even clipped in, so it can't even come out now. So there you go, guys. That's how you change over your door handle for your W204. Now to reinstall this, all you have to do is make sure you tuck it back in and everything lines up as it should. You separate the top piece, but also push down on this bottom piece here to give you room to install this back inside, because you need to get this inside here and you need to get these holes over these tabs. All right, we'll get that in there. There we go. And then make sure this tab comes up here and these two come through the top. Ensure all these other tabs line up. So you lift it up, separate this piece, and then push down here so you can get it in, because this piece sits in between these two pieces. You just have to use these screws and screw everything back in, and that will hold it back together again. So let's grab our screws and we'll screw everything in. If you don't see that there is a hole for your screw, I just get a drill and drill a little hole, not too much, just a little hole, so that the screw can go back into it. If you drill too far, you're going to go through the leather, so you don't want to do that. See how easily the screw goes in now? Seems all these ones don't have a hole, so I'm just going to make a little hole in them so we can put a screw in. Once you have put all the screws in, it should look pretty flush. Just check it out. We'll have a look here. Make sure everything does look as it once did. Okay, no loose parts. Everything is back together real nice. Okay, so it's still a bit dirty here, so I'm just going to wipe this off, get it all clean. All I like to use is, if you use chemicals, your interior can actually start to deteriorate, so you don't want that. I want to make sure it's nice and clean, so I'm going to get my air blower and I'm going to blow. Well, there you have it, guys. How to 204. Now, this also applies to other Mercedes-Benz models as well. So if your Mercedes-Benz has the same door handle as this, I ring that notification bell in order to